morning, students. Today we'll continue the session limits and derivatives in that derivatives. Okay. If y is equal to f of x is a real valued function, then with a change in value of x, if I consider y is equal to f of x, which is a real valued function, then change in value of x, there will be a change in value of y. If x changes to delta x, if x is changes to delta x, then delta x is called change in x. Okay. Then delta x is called change in x. So f of x plus dx is equals to f of x plus dx is equals to y plus delta y. Okay, f of x plus dx is equals to y plus delta y. Then delta y is called change in y. Then delta y, this delta y is called change in y. Okay. So the ratio delta x to delta y is equals to f of x plus delta x minus f of x divided by delta x is called the incremental ratio. This ratio delta x divided by delta y is equals to this incremental ratio delta y divided by delta x is called the incremental ratio. And this one, no? This delta y delta x f of x plus delta x minus f of x divided by delta x, it is called incremental ratio, and it is expressed in terms of rate of change of y with respect to x. This, if I am applying this limit delta y delta x as x tends to 0, this is called derivative. Okay. This one is called derivative. Okay. This is called the derivative. Okay. So what is the derivative? Limit delta y divided by delta x as x tends to 0, which is equals to f of x plus delta x minus f of x divided by delta x. So this is, the whole thing is nothing but f dash of x. Therefore, f dash of x is equal to f of x plus delta x minus f of x divided by delta x is called LB initio method or delta method. This one is called AB initio method. Okay. Or delta method. Okay. So this is the derivative definition. So if y is equal to f of x is a real value function, then the change in x, there will be a change in y. So if x changes to delta x, then delta x is called change in y. Okay. If I consider y is equal to f of x and it is a real value function, so if x, there is a change, then the change in x, there will be also a change in y. If x changes to delta x, then this delta x is called change in x. Similarly, f of x plus delta x is equals to f of x plus delta x is equals to this one, no? Y plus delta y. So this delta y is called change in y. So this ratio delta y divided by delta x, which is equals to f of x plus delta x minus f of x divided by delta x, is called the, this one, it is expressed in terms of this one, delta y by delta x as limit x tends to 0, and this one is called this one, derivative. Okay. So the whole thing, if I apply this one as x tends to 0, this limit as x tends to 0, then this one is called the derivative. and this one is the rate of change of this one, okay. So rate of change of y with respect to x, so limiting value of this when delta x tends to 0, so is called the derivative and it is denoted by dy by dx, okay. So this one is called the incremental ratio. This is nothing but incremental ratio. It is a rate of, it is expressed in terms of rate of change of y, the average rate of change of y with respect to x, okay. So so this one is called the dy by dx or f dash of x. The whole thing is nothing but this f dash of x or dy by dx, okay. You just understand this y is equal to f of x is a real value function, then there is a change in x, there will be a change in y also. If x changes to delta x, then delta x is called change in y. So f of x plus so delta x is equal to y plus delta y. So change in this delta y is called change in y. Okay. This delta y is called change in y. So therefore delta y by delta x is equal to f of x plus delta x minus f of x squared by delta x. This is the, this one is called the incremental ratio. Okay. So the limiting value of this delta y, this ratio, limiting value of this delta y divided by delta x as x tends to 0 is called derivative and is denoted by this one dy by dx. This, the whole thing is denoted by dy by dx or f dash of x, both are same, okay. Dy by dx is nothing but f dash of x. So f dash of x is equal to f of x plus delta x minus f of x divided by delta x, okay. So this is the ab initio method or delta method. Okay, this one we can also edit as next time. Okay, next we solve more problems. We are going to write the derivative in terms of a tricky. So this theorems, the derivations are very, very important. It is going to be coming in the examination for 3 months, okay? How it will be the question? The question is like this, derived like by using the first principle. It is going to be coming like this. Let me how it is going to be the question. Okay, find the derivative of, okay. Compute the derivative of sin x by using the first principles. Okay, they are going to ask the question like this. Compute the derivative of sin x. Okay, compute. The next one is compute the derivative of sin x with respect to x by using the first principle. Or are they going to ask like this also? Find the derivative of f of x, which is equal to sin x, by the method of first principles. They are going to ask like this also, okay? So, these three, there are three derivations in this chapter. Okay, after the Lambda formulas, you have to remember. So, these three derivations now, among these three derivations, any one of the derivation may ask in the examination. So, these three derivations are very, very important, okay? So, the heading is derivative of some standard trigonometric functions, okay? Derivatives of some standard trigonometric functions. Derivative of some standard trigonometric functions. The question will be like this. Find the derivative of, find the derivative of f of x is equal to sin x by the method of by by the method of first principles. By the method of first principles. So this is the half left hand side x is equal to a limit x tends to 0, f of x plus h minus f of x divided by h. So this formula you have to remember, this is the first principle method. F dash of x is equal to limit of f of x plus h minus f of x divided by h as h tends to 0. What is f of x here? F of x is equal to this sine x now. So then what will be f of x plus h? So f of x plus h is equal to sine of x plus h. Okay, this is very important. So they have given itself f of x is equal to sine x, f of x plus h is equal to sine of x plus h. Okay, so we are substituting here in this first principle, limit h tends to 0. This one we can write like this also, d by dx of this is sine x, no, f of x is sine x. So limit h tends to 0, what is f of x plus h? Here we are substituting this value here, okay. So sine of x plus h minus f of x is equal to sine x divided by h, okay. So very, very important. We have to write first this derivative of this by the method of first principles, f dash of x is equal to limit h tends to 0, f of x plus h minus f of x divided by h. So here f of x is equal to sine x, then what will be f of x plus h, which is equal to sine of x plus h. Okay. So after this, in trigonometric functions, we have learnt this sine x minus sine y is equal to 2 cos of x plus y divided by 2. So this sine of x minus y divided by 2. So we have to remember this formula, trigonometric functions of this one, half angles, okay. So we have proved these theorems also. This one sine x minus sine y is equal to 2 cos of x plus y divided by 2 sine of x minus y divided by 2. We have to remember this formula. Why we have to remember? Because it is of sine x minus sine y. So this numerator is of the form sine x minus sine y is equal to 2 cos of x plus y divided by 2 sine of x minus y divided by 2. What is x here? You can compare this one, okay? So x is nothing but x plus h and this y is nothing but this sine x, okay? This is this x. That's all we can do that, which is equal to limit h tends to 0, where this one we are substituting here. 2 cos of x is what? X is x plus h plus y is x divided by k. So into sine of x is x plus h minus y is x divided by k. So this step is also important. 4 divided by what is there? 4 divided by h is there. Okay. So we have to write like this first. First, what we have to write? We have to write the method, the first principle law, formula, f dash of x, what is f dash of x? F dash of x is equal to limit h tends to 0, this f of x plus h minus f of x divided by h, okay? We have to write this formula first. After that, f of x is sine x, no? Here they are given, we have to prove the derivative of f of x is equal to sine x. So what will be the f of x plus h? F of x plus h is sine of x plus h. If f of x is equal to sine x, f of x plus h is nothing but sine of x plus h. Here x is replaced as x plus h. You just remember that. Substitute in this first principle method, f of x plus h is nothing but sine of x plus h minus f of x is sin x divided by h. So it is of the form sin x minus sin y formula. In trigonometric functions we have learned the sin x minus sin y is equals to 2 cos of x plus y divided by 2. This formula, 2 cos of x plus y divided by 2 into sin of x minus y divided by 2. Here x is equals to what? X is nothing but x plus h. Y is x, okay. We are substituting, instead of this x, we are substituting x plus h. Instead of y, we are substituting x, okay. So what is going to be here? 2 cos of x plus h. So it is nothing but x, no? X can be replaced as x plus h plus y is x divided by 2 into sin of this x is x plus h. Minus is there, that's why I'm putting minus. Minus y is this one now. X divided by 2, the whole divided by h, okay? The whole divided by h. So we have to write like this. After this, what we have to do? Next one. So here you see, look at here. So x plus x is 2x now. And this x and this x will get cancelled. You will get, so limit h tends to 0, 2 cos of this 2x plus h, okay, 2x plus h into sin of this one. H, sin h, you can write like this directly, sin h. This after cancelling this sin h divided by 2, okay, the whole divided by 2 is there, here the whole divided by 2 is there, whole divided by h, okay. It is going to be, after remaining the x plus x adding this, it is going to be 2x, and x is going to be cancelled, you will get sin h divided by 2, so sin h divided by 2. Here 2 cos of 2x plus h divided by 2 whole divided by 2. Okay, we know that in the previous class we have proved one theorem, sin x divided by x as limit x tends to 0, which is equals to 1. Okay, so here this the value of this limit sin theta by theta as theta tends to 0 is equals to 1. We have proved in our earlier classes. That is limit sin theta by theta as theta tends to 0 is equals to 1. Similarly, so we can substitute this sin h by 2 is there and here h is there. If I multiply here and divide, so what is going to be our termination? Okay. So in the next step, we have to write. So I am going to multiply and dividing by 2 in the denominator. So it is going to be next up the limit x tends to 0, 2 cos of 2x plus h divided by 2 into this sin h by 2 is there, this one, okay, sin h by 2. Better write like this only, sin h by 2. So 4 divided by, you can write like this, 2 into h by 2. Okay. So 2 will get cancelled. After this, so split and write. Okay, this one you're going to split and write. So this is equals to limit h tends to 0. So cos of 2x plus h divided by 2, okay, into limit h by 2 is going to be changed. This limit as h tends to 0, it is going to be h tends to 2. This sin h by 2 divided by h by 2. So now I can apply the value of this is equals to 1. So it is going to be limit h tends to 0. So cos of 2x plus h divided by 2. So substitute h tends to 0, h has 0, okay, in which d by dx of this f of x is equals to what is this one? So cos of 2x plus cancel. So d by dx of, what is f of x? F of x is nothing but sin x, no? Sin x is equal to cos x, okay? So very, very important result. It means the derivative of sin x is equal to cos x, okay? So the derivative of sin x is equal to cos x. So this is one of the formula, okay? So derivative of sin x is equal to cos x. So how it is going to become? We have proved this one by the method of first principles, okay? What is the method of first principle? So the method of first principle is equal to this one, that is f of dash of x is equal to f of x plus h minus f of x divided by h. So you take the first principle method formula. So f of x is equal to sin x, f dash of x is equal to sin of x plus h, okay? Substitute here, okay? After that you get this one, the sin x minus sin y formula, you will get 2 cos of x plus y divided by 2 into sin of x minus y divided by 2. Substitute where x is equal to x plus h and y is equal to x. Substitute, you will get a bit, try to simplify like this. It is very simple, okay? So this one is very simple. You get like this now. So after this, we have to get it into h by 2. Here is h by 2. So we can use a limit x tends to 0, sin x divided by x is equal to 1. Then here, the value of that is equal to 1 now. We have proved in the earlier classes. So if it is 1, so this is going to be limit h tends to 0, cos of 2x plus h divided by 2. Substitute as x tends to 0, you will get this 2 will get cancelled now. This 2 will get cancelled. It is going to remain only cos x. So the derivative of sin x is equal to cos x. You just remember that, okay? Similarly, find the derivative of how do we do the question? Find the derivative of f of x is equal to cos x by the method of the first principles, okay? Find the derivative of f of x is equal to cos x. So another theorem, this is one of the theorem. So any theorem may ask in the derivative. Any derivative may ask in the examination. So it will definitely come in the examination. Try to practice it, okay? Try to understand and try to practice it. Next one, find the derivative of f of x is equal to cos x. This is second theorem, okay? Same by the method of first principles. What is the method of first principle? This one. F first, you have to write f dash of x is equal to limit h tends to 0 f of x plus h minus f of x divided by h. This formula you have to write first, okay? After that, f of x is cos x. What will be f of x plus h? What will be x, f of x plus h? F of x plus h, x is replaced by x plus h, okay? So which is equal to cos of x plus h, okay? So substitute here. So d by dx of cos x is equal to limit h tends to 0. F of x plus h is what? Cos of x plus h minus f of x is cos x whole divided by this whole divided by h. Okay. So now it is a cos x minus cos y formula. We have to remember this cos x, cos y. I am going to write it somewhere. Cos x minus cos y is equal to minus 2 sin of x plus y divided by 2. Okay. So you have to remember this formula. Very, very important. Cos x minus cos y is equal to, because why I have written cos x, cos y here? It is cos x and cos y. Consider this as y, consider this as x. Cos x minus cos y is equal to minus 2 sin of x plus y divided by 2 into sin of x minus y divided by 2. So after that, you apply the formula. So cos x minus cos y is equal to minus 2 sine of x plus y divided by 2 into sine of x minus y divided by 2. Okay. So what is the next step? So we need h tends to 0. This one, okay. For this we use this minus 2 sine of x is x plus h, y is x divided by 2. Okay. Minus 2 sine of x plus y divided by 2 into sine of x minus y, x plus h minus x divided by 2. Whole joint, right? This h is there now. Whole joint, right? H, okay. After this, we get 2x now. Next step, limit h tends to 0, minus 2 sine of 2x plus h divided by 2. Okay, you know, see this one? Limit h tends to 0, minus 2 sine of x plus x is 2x plus h divided by 2 into this sine of this will get cancelled, h divided by 2 all divided by h, okay? All divided by h. So after this, what we have to do? So we have to divide both this here now we have to multiply and divide that. Here. So how it is going to be? It is equal to limit h tends to 0 minus 2 sine of 2x plus h divided by 2 and 4 divided by. So I'm splitting this one, okay? I'm splitting this one into limit h tends to h tends to 0 h limit h tends to this one, no? H tends to h divided by 2. So this one, this sine h by 2. However, you can write h tends to 0 also, okay, no problem, h tends to 0. Sine h by 2 into h by 2 into this 2 will come, no? This 2 and 2. So I'm going to cancel it here. 2, 2 will be cancelled. So otherwise, you can write in the next step here, okay? 1 by 2 taking as this 2 constant. You take this 1 by 2 as outside, you keep this one limit. H tends to 0, minus 2 sine of 2x plus h divided by 2. And this 2 now you take it outside like this. 1 by 2 you take it outside. So it will be remaining the term is sine h by 2. Okay, I am going to write it here. So what we have to write, I am writing this one again, so limit h tends to 0 minus 2 sine of 2x plus h divided by 2 into limit h tends to 0. So this one 1 by 2 is there now here, you can take constant outside like this, okay, limit h tends to 0 sine h by 2. So divided by h by 2. The whole thing is going to be 1. Why it is 1? We know that limit theta tends to 0 as sine x divided by x is equal to 1. Okay. So we can substitute here as 1 because using this formula x, well, x is nothing but h by 2 and this x is nothing but h by 2. And h is nothing but here, this one. If we can write h by 2 tends to 0 also this because this has to be right, okay? And this one, h tends to 0 is going to be h by 2 tends to 0, okay? So we can apply this one. After this, see this 2 will get cancelled. So limit h tends to 0. I will get to this, after getting this cancel, I will get minus sine of 2x plus h divided by 2. And the value, the whole thing is going to be 1, okay? So substitute h tends to 0, which is equal to this minus sine of this 2x plus 0 divided by 2. This could be to the answer, which is equal to minus sine x. Therefore, d by dx of cos x is equal to minus sine x. It means the derivative of cos x is equal to minus sine x. Okay? So this is the second derivation. Which is the second derivation? Find the derivative of y is equal to y is nothing but f of x now. F of x is equal to cos x by using the first principle. So this is the first principle. So f of x is equal to cos x. F of x plus h is cos of x plus h. Okay? So substitute here, if you get this cos x minus cos y formula. Apply cos x minus cos y formula. So limit x tends to 0. This limit x tends to 0 sin x divided by x is equal to 1. So after using that, it is going to be 1. Left hand side, it is going to be like this. So after getting this two is going to be cancelled. This after getting h tends to 0, you will get sine of 2x plus 0 divided by 2, which is equal to, you will get remaining only that minus sine x. So the derivative of cosine cos x is nothing but minus sine x. These two are the important formula, okay? So these two are the important formula. So we are going to simplify this one, okay? By using this product rule. Next one is here, that is find the derivative of f of x is equal to tan x by using the first principle, that is the third derivation. F of x is equal to tan x by using the first principle. This is the third derivation. So any derivation may come in the examination. Okay. What is the first principle method? F dash of x is equal to limit x tends to 0, this one now, f of x plus h minus f of x divided by h, okay? So this is the first principle method. So what is f of x plus h? So tan of x plus h, okay? So f dash of x is equal to, so limit h tends to 0, f of x plus h is nothing but this tan of x plus h. You have to be very careful. Minus f of x is tan x over right h. So f of x is equal to tan x. What is f of x plus h? F of x plus h is tan of x plus h. Okay. So this one I am substituting here in the first principle. Limit h tends to 0, f of x plus h minus f of x divided by h. So you know that tan x is equal to what? Tan x is equal to sin x divided by cos x. This is the formula. Tan x is equal to sin x divided by cos x. So instead of tan x, you can write sin x divided by cos x. Limit h tends to 0, tan x sin of x plus h divided by cos of x plus h minus tan x sin x divided by cos x all divided by h. Okay, this one. After this, you cross multiply this one. So how is this going to be? So limit h tends to 0. Cross multiplication, sin of x plus h into cos x. Sin of x plus h into cos x minus cos of x plus h. Cos of x plus h into sin x. All divided by this. So it is going to be like this. Okay, this value and this value. Okay. So h of cos of h into cos x. Okay, so I'm just this one I'm writing in terms of tan x is nothing but sin x by cos x. I'm writing tan x is sin x by cos x. After that, taking LCM, okay, taking LCM, so it is going to be like this. Again, sin x cos y, sin x cos y minus cos x sin y. It is also one of the formula. That is sin of x minus y. This is nothing but sin of x minus y. So it is already in the expanded form. So sin of x minus y is equals to sin x cos y minus cos x sin y. So which is equals to limit h tends to 0. It is of the form sin of x for x minus y. Sin of x is here, x plus h minus y is here, x again. So divided by h of cos of x plus h into cos x. You have to be very careful, okay? Okay? So these two will get cancelled. Limit h tends to 0, it is going to be remaining sin h divided by h, okay? I'm splitting, okay? If you don't limit h tends to 0, so numerator 1 is there, no? After taking here this one, cos of x plus h, cos of x plus h into cos x, okay? It is going to be like this. You know that the value of this is equal to 1. Why it is 1? Because we have learnt the derivation of sin x divided by x as x tends to 0 is equals to 1. This value is going to be 1, okay? So what is remaining? You will get only this. Limit x tends to 0, 1 divided by cos of x plus h into cos x. So when h tends to 0, this is going to be 1 divided by cos x into cos x. You know that cos x into cos x is equals to cos square x. So it is equals to 1 divided by cos square x. So reciprocal of cos x is the secant x. So 1 by cos x is secant x. Similarly, 1 by cos square x is secant square x. Therefore, d by dx of f dash of x is this one, not tan x, f of x. This is nothing but f dash of x. Tan x is equals to 1 divided by cos square x is nothing but secant square x. This is one of the most important formula, okay? So this is the one of the most important formula. So I just practice among the three derivations now. Sin x, cos x, derivative of sin x is cos x. Derivative of cos x is minus sin x. And the derivative of tan x is secant square x. In the next session, we are going to solve. So very, very important problems regarding this 5 marks also it is going to become. In every branch, it is coming part A, part B, part C, part D. So part E also it is coming, okay? So in all the branches in calculus part is coming. So in next year now, that is what I am telling. So you have to be very careful. If you learn this one, if you learn this one now, it is going to be easy for second year, okay? So this is the derivative of tan x by using the first principle. How it is going to be? You just consider f of x is equal to tan x. Then what is f of x plus h, which is equals to tan of x plus h. So what is the first principle method? F dash of x is equals to limit h tends to 0 f of x plus h minus f of x h minus f of x divided by h. Okay. After that, limit h tends to 0. So this will be substitute here. F is nothing but tan of x plus h minus tan x divided by h. So tan x can be written as sin x divided by cos x. No, tan x is in terms of sin x divided by cos x, right? In terms of sin x divided by cos x, taking cross multiplication, okay? And these two will comes together like this. So this is of sin A cos B minus cos A sin B, which is equals to sin of A minus B. Sin of A minus B is equals to sin A cos B minus cos A sin B. This is one of the important formula. Sin of X minus Y is equals to sin X sin Y minus cos X cos Y. So I am applying this one. After this, these two will get cancelled. Sin H is in the numerator. So in the denominator, you will get H of cos X plus H cos X. Okay, after substituting H is equals to 0, you will get 1 by cos X into 1 by cos X. 1 by cos X, 1 by cos X. You know it's the reciprocal of the cos X is secant X. 1 by cos X is nothing but secant X. So 1 by cos square x is nothing but secant square x, okay, secant square x. So the derivative of tan x is equal to secant square x. So very, very important formula, okay. So what are the three derivations we have learned here today? First, these are the formula I have to give, but okay. So dy dx of this sin x is equals to cos x, and d by dx of cos x is equals to minus sin x, which d by dx of tan x is equals to secant square x. So these are the three important formulas we have learned today, okay. So try to practice this, okay. And there is one more formula is that d by dx of x raised to n is equals to n x n minus 1. Okay. For example, if we ask find the derivative of this x cube, what you are going to write this one? So find the derivative of x cube. Find the derivative of y is equals to x cube. How we are going to ask, how I find the derivative of f of x is equals to x cube. So y is nothing but f of x. F of x is equals to y, no, it's a function. So y is equals to x cube, or f of x is equals to x cube, they can ask, okay. So we have to differentiate f dash of x. What is here, if you are using this one, okay. This derivative of x raised to n is equals to n x n minus 1. N is what here? 3. X, same you put x. N minus 1 is 3 minus 1. Here, n is a constant and x is a variable. This n is a constant and x is a variable. We have to remember. So in the next year, we are getting this logarithmic differentiation also there. There is a function in the index, okay. Here there is a constant this one in the index. This is a constant, no? X cube. X in that x cube, 3 is a constant, x is a variable. So if it is a constant and index, you have to use this n x raised to n minus 1. So which is equals to 3, x raised to 3 minus 1 is 2. So d by dx of x cube is equals to dx square. So very important, you see, look at here, x cube, no? 3 will going to come here. This one is a positive integer, right? So 3 will come here. x cube minus 1, you do it, okay? X cube minus 1 is x square, no? It is going to be reduced. X cube is going to be reduced as x square, okay? So 3 is going to come here, x cube is going to be x square. What about this one? To write 99, this x 99 is going to be what? It is my minus 1 you do. It is going to be reduced minus 1. Okay. So x 99 is going to be x 98. So this is the differentiation of x raised to 99. Okay. We are going to solve the problems regarding this x raised to n and the derivative of sin x, derivative of cos x and derivative of tan x. Okay. In the next session.